Hi guys, I am Shoham Day and I am here to give a presentation on the assignment that has been given to me by the Skyfi Labs. Now, this is the building model that is shown here and this is the plan view of it. Now, the building is consisting of 23 stories. Now, also the dead load and the live load are varying according to the different stories. Now, also the beam and the column sections are also given here. And the grade of concrete and grade of steel are also given, and the slab depth is also given. Cladding load and wind load is as per the location of Bangalore. Then I will show you the building model that I have created and go through the different steps that I have performed to design, to analyze and design this structure. Now, as first we need to create this grid over here that is given here. Then after that we need to define the material properties, the material that are the grade of concrete and the grade of steel. Here grade of steel are FYSD 500 and mile 250. After that we need to define the section properties. The section property include the beam and the column and also the slabs. Now at first we will define the beam properties and also the column properties. The beam of properties are given here 500 into 300, 550 by 350, 600 into 400, and also column properties 500, 500, 550, 550, 600, 650. Now we need to create an auto selection list for the beam and as well as for the column. Now I will show you the auto selection list over here. As you can see, the auto selected beams are 550, 300, 550 into 350, 600 into 400. This is the auto selection list over here. Then after that, the column similarly has also been done over here, as you can see. Now, then after this we need to select or define the slab section. For the slab section properties we need to select 150 thickness of the slab. Now as you can see, I have given a slab name, the concrete grade, and also the slab type as slab, and also the thickness as 150. We need to click OK and click OK to assign the property. Then after that we need to define the wind load case. Now we will go to the load patterns and we will select here as wind. Then we will select the type as wind again over here. Then we will select the IS code as IS 875 1987 and click on OK. This is how the load is defined, or the wind load is defined. Now after this we need to draw the beam, the column and also the slab. We will use the quick draw beam / column option and quick draw column for beam and column respectively. And for the slabs we will select the quick draw floor wall plan. This is how the slab and the columns are being drawn. Now after this we will assign the loads. Now first load that I am assigning is the cladding load. For the cladding load we will select the peripheral beams and we will go to assign. We will select frame loads and we will select distributed. Here we will assign 0.2 kilonewton per meter load and we will click on OK and the load will get applied, and I will display you the load that I have assigned. Now as you can see, 0.2 kilonewton load has been applied on the peripheral walls as cladding loads. Now after that we will assign the dead loads and the live loads on the slabs. So we'll go to the assign, go to cell loads, and we'll go to uniform, and in uniform we will select the load according to the problem statement, the dead load and also the live load, and you'll click on OK and it will get applied. Now I will display you the loads. We'll go to display, load assign, and we'll go to shell. Now we will select dead load and click on OK. Now as you can see, 2 kiloNewton load has been given on the slab. Now after that, in similar ways we can see the live load also. Now after that, we'll assign the wind load. For wind load, we need cladding all across the building. For cladding, we will go to draw, and we will auto, will go to the option auto draw cladding. When we will select that, the claddings will be given all over the building. Now after this, we will go to assign, we will select all the claddings that depending on the windward side, leeward side, and etc. We'll go to assign, then we'll go to shell loads, we'll go to wind pressure coefficient, and we will give the coefficient of the wind load. And the coefficient of wind load can be obtained from the IS code. Then after that, we need to get the CPE value. How we'll get the CPE value? That is also depends on the length, breadth, and also the height of the building. Now depending on the side on which the building is facing, for example, here this is the windward side. Suppose this is the windward side, these all three other sides are the leeward sides. So according to that, the CPE value will vary. Then after assigning, I will display the wind loads. Now as you can see, I'm displaying the wind loads. Now you can see that wind load has been assigned to the building. Now after that, we will run the analysis. We'll go to analysis and we'll go to run the analysis. Now the analysis is running and the building is too big, so the analysis will take some time. Now as you see on the right hand side of the screen, the building is showing a deformed shape. This is because due to the loads. Now I will display the undeformed shape. Now you can see the undeformed shape. Now we will perform the design part. Now we'll go to design, we'll go to concrete frame design, and we will go to view and revise preferences. Here we need to select the IS code as IS 456-2000. Then we need to select click OK. All other things will be same. After that, again we will go to design, then concrete frame, then we will select start design and check. And this option will help us to design the building according to the analysis report. As you can see, the analysis is going on. The building is quite big, so it will take some time. Now as you can see, report has come that analysis and design sections are different for 6 frame. This means that the analysis is done on different section, and the design is done on different section. So if you select on yes, then it will design the same section as the analysis section. Now we will select on no. Now we will check whether our section are failing or it is passing. We will go to design and we will go to verify all member passed. And as you can see, all the frame passed the design check. So we need not to design again or define any section for this. Now what we will do that what we will do that we will see the reports of this building. Now, as you can see, there are two reports. One is the project report and the summary report. Now, we will get all the forces, all the reinforcement details, all these things from these reports. Now, thank you for Skyfieldland for helping me to learn this very useful software. This is quite user friendly, and I think this is the best software in the market. And thank you for listening to me.